We've learned that FBI investigators are now on the ground in Niger, helping to collect evidence following that deadly ambush that killed four U.S. troops. Meanwhile, there are already calls for what some are suggesting could be a Benghazi-style investigation by Congress into this attack. And Senator John McCain has already said he may actually go ahead and subpoena individuals to get answers to all of this. The former CIA Director James Woolsey is here with us. He formerly served as a senior advisor to the Trump campaign. So, Director Woolsey, thanks so much for joining us. What questions do you want answered as far as the death of these four U.S. troops?
Well, I think the most important thing is that this is the future face of Africa. Not only are we going to be seeing lots of immigration from Africa up into Europe, we're going to be seeing terrorist events and attacks in northern Africa and the Sahara as basically the Islamists struggle with everybody else.
So what does
for
that
control.
Mean for the U.S.?
Means the United States is going to see more events like this terrible one that we have evidently seen recently. We're going to have forces there that are well equipped, better equipped than this small group was. And we're going to have to rely very heavily on the local military forces and train them and cooperate with them and learn from them.
But do you think that keeping significant numbers of U.S. military personnel in Niger and other countries in Africa is an important is important for the U.S. or should they get out?
Well, if you get out, you turn Africa over to the Islamists.
The African governments can't deal with these terrorists?
Not alone, I don't think. I think they need help and cooperation, and we need to learn from them.
Because France is involved, Britain is involved. What about the Europeans? Why can't they get the job done in Africa? Well, why does the United States always need to go in and assist?
Well, the French are probably the best equipped and best trained to do this now, and they've been there for a long time, centuries. We don't do well when we assume victory and leave. That's what we did with the aircraft carrier, remember, with George W. Bush. That's what happened when President Obama decided, well, the surge has worked, we'll pull everybody out, and what came in? ISIS. So if you don't care about the Islamists controlling increasingly the Middle East, but certainly the northern part of Africa, then you can shrug and say goodbye.
So your point is keep these thousands of U.S. military personnel in various countries in Africa, but make sure they're better protected, that U.S. intelligence is better, because clearly there were some major mistakes that led to the killing of these four U.S. troops.
Yeah. Work closely with the locals, with the Nigerians, with the French who are there all the time, with the British and others. We've got to be serious about this. We can't just kind of dabble with it and declare victory the way it's been done before once we decide to leave.
I want to get your reaction to something that's happened over the past day or so. The current CIA director, your former CIA director, Mike Pompeo, he was at an event and he spoke about Russian meddling in the U.S. presidential election last year. Let me play the exchange he had with a journalist.
Can you say with absolute certainty that the election results were not skewed as a result of Russian interference, especially given what we've learned just in the last few weeks? And more importantly, are we vulnerable in 2018?
Well, I'm not sure there could be. I'm not sure there could be anything more important than that.
Okay.
That we conducted an election that had integrity. And yes, the intelligence community's assessment is that the Russian meddling that took place did not affect the outcome of the election.
All right, now he made a mistake because that was not the intelligence community's assessment. They had to issue a statement following what the director said, pointing out that the intelligence community's assessment was that they couldn't make a final determination whether any votes were changed. They did conclude the Russians interfered. They did conclude the Russians wanted to sow dissent in the U.S., wanted to undermine Hillary Clinton and help Donald Trump, but they could not conclude that actual voting results had changed, so they fixed what the director had said.
Well, there's a difference between it being skewed and it changing the outcome. Things, if it had gone from a 70-30 vote to a 51-49 vote because of Russian meddling, but the same side had still won, the outcome might have been skewed, but it was not changed. And I think that bouncing back and forth between definitions of affecting and affecting fundamentally and so forth is one of the sources of confusion.
Yeah, well, he said flatly that it did not affect the outcome of the election. So in other words, what you're suggesting is what Pompeo said was accurate?
Yes, I think if it didn't affect the outcome, but that's what he said.
But and the CIA put out a statement fixing what he said.
It's still skewed means turned or twisted and perhaps changed somewhat.
Because the original intelligence community report, and I'm looking at it, did not assess whether Russia had successfully impacted the election, only that they interfered for various purposes, but did not conclude that they had actually impacted the election.
Well, that's yet another word to play with in here. And you can impact something and skew it and still not change the outcome. The key question in terms of the past election is whether it affected the outcome. It apparently did not. The next election, which we ought to be getting ready for right now, is up for grabs. We don't want Mr. Putin casting our votes because people made changes back just after 2000 in the electoral machinery and electronics and thought it would be a good idea to get rid of all paper trails. Well, that was really a dumb decision because you only can do a vote count if you have a paper trail.
The Russians haven't stopped.
Oh, absolutely not. They've been doing this since the 1930s in one way or another. What's new is they're doing it with cyber. But they're interfering with people's elections? Oh, Russians think nothing of that.
They're doing it with cyber and social media very actively as well. All right, former director of the CIA, James Woolsey, thanks very much.
Good to be with you.
Extraordinary attack.